friends.
Good morning,
friends.
Good morning, sir.
अरे सुबह का वक्त है 7:30 बजे और इतना डर हो सभी के सभी लोग. Yes, good morning, everyone.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning, my friends. Welcome to my new video on Easy Economics. As I have promised you, I will be helping out the students who will be appearing for this particular February 2019 examinations. So going ahead with this, I will be bringing in small videos on this particular subject. So in this particular video, I will be helping students out with question number 6, that is answer in detail. You have 2 questions to be answered out of 4, which carries 16 marks of weightage. Before I start with the question, let me tell you the 4 chapters from which the question number 6 will be asked. Chapter number 1 is 3A, that is demand chapter. 3B, elasticity chapter, national income chapter, and determinants of aggregate. These are the 4 chapters which have to be focused for question number 6. Which are the important questions in this chapter? I will bring videos on each and every question. Right? So in this particular video, the chapter demand, right? 3A, 3A demand chapter, will be discussing the most important question for question number 6. If you just check the board papers past 10 years, not even a single examination has been left out where there is not even a single question asked on this particular concept, that is the law of demand. And I assure you, this is my 100% guess that you will compulsorily have question number 6, one question, that is explain law of demand. Friends, it's a good pattern that they do not just ask law of demand, but they'll also ask you also write assumptions or exceptions. If you just go through the board papers, you will realize in the past March 2019 examinations, exceptions to law of demand were being asked. Exceptions to law of demand were asked. So it is my guess that this time explain law of demand and also explain assumptions will be asked in coming February 2020 examinations. Still, we cannot give excuse. We will prepare assumptions as well as exceptions. Right? So coming to question number 6, explain law of demand. There are a lot of queries regarding students, how do we write law? How do we write a particular law? There is a set pattern to write a particular law, be it law of demand or diminishing marginal utility or any other law. Right? How is the pro forma? How it is to be written so that you can score 7% mark, that is 100 marks is to be taken care of. Right? Let me explain you the format first, how it is to be written. Explain law of demand. How do we write? These are the 7 major points. These are the 7 major points which have to be taken care of. Which have to be taken care while writing this particular question, right? First is the introduction of the law. First is the introduction of the law. Second is statement of the law. What is the statement of the law? What is the law saying, right? Then you have to write explanation of statement. Then you have to write explanation of statement. After that, you can write schedule. After that, you have to write the schedule. You also have to explain the schedule. You also have to explain the schedule. After writing down the explanation of schedule, you have to draw the diagram on the law. Right? Whatever diagram you have in your textbook, the same kind of diagram is to be drawn. After drawing diagram, you have to explain that particular diagram. This is the particular prescribed format for students appearing for board examination as to how do we write a particular law. Not only for HSC board students, this is also being suggested for students who are also appearing for CBSE, okay, right? So let's go ahead with law of demand, right? So introduction, first point here is introduction. There are 2 simple points which you can write in the first heading or first point, that is introduction. What are the 2 points?
Law of demand was introduced by
Professor Alfred Marshall. Exactly. The first point would be the law of demand is propounded by Professor Alfred Marshall. In which book he has written this particular law?
Principle of Economics.
Right? So the second point you can write is published in the book Principle of Economics. Right? As we all know, Adam Smith is the father of economics. Major theories of the microeconomics are propounded or given by Professor Alfred Marshall, right? So it would be right on our part to denote Professor Alfred Marshall as the real father of microeconomics, right? So this is the introduction which we have to write. What is the first point we are going to write?
Introduction.
Introduction mein pehla point kya hoga?
This law is propounded by Professor Alfred Marshall.
The law of demand is propounded by Professor Alfred Marshall. What is the second point we are going to write?
Statement of law.
What is the second point in the introduction we are going to write?
It was explained in detail in his book.
It was explained in detail in his book titled Principles of Economics. This is introduction with the 2 points we have to write in the introduction. Next is statement of law. What is given in the statement of law? Can you read? Other things remaining same and constant.
As the price of product increases, demand for the product decreases, and as the price of product decreases, the demand for the product increases.
This is wrong.
This is wrong.
According to Alfred Marshall, other things remaining same and constant, higher the price of the commodity, lower is its demand. Lower in its demand, and lower the price of the commodity, higher is its demand. This is what is given in the statement. You can also read this in your textbook. Whatever you have been saying, when the price increases, demand decreases, price decreases, demand increases, is explanation of the statement. This point has to be written in the explanation of the statement. Ensure whenever you write a statement of a law, write as it is, which is given in your textbook. If you can just open that textbook and again read what is given in the statement of law of demand.
Other things being constant, the higher the price of the commodity, smaller is the quantity demanded, and lower the price of the commodity, larger is the quantity demanded.
Yes. So first, let us understand other things remaining same and constant. Other things remaining same and constant, which is also called as ceteris paribus. You have learned earlier part of this particular chapter that there are various factors which affect demand, right? So if we have to analyze the effect of price on particular demand of a commodity, we need to ensure that the rest of the factors are constant. Hence it is assumed at the start of the law, other things remaining same and constant, right? Now this is the statement of law which we have written, right? After the statement of law comes the explanation of the statement. What we have to write in the explanation? We have to explain whatever is given in the statement. Now easier point is to be written in simple words. When the price of the product increases, demand for the product decreases. When the price of the product decreases, demand for the product increases. Yes or no?
Yes.
Right. Price increases, demand decreases. Price decreases, demand increases. Yes or no? अरे 7:30 बजे सुबह का वक्त है. Be loud. हाय ना. Right. Very good. Right. So price increases, demand decreases. Price decreases, demand increases. Demand increases. See, both the variables are moving in opposite direction. Both the variables are moving in opposite direction. Yes or no?
Yes.
Right. So whenever there is an inverse relationship, if we draw a curve denoting those two variables, it will always have a negative slope. That is, the slope of the curve would be downward sloping from left to right. Right? So, what can be understood? That when price increases, demand decreases. When price decreases, demand increases. So, what is the next point you can write in the explanation of the statement? Hence, there is a inverse relationship between price of the commodity and its quantity demanded. Yes or no?
Yes.
Ayana. Right. Moving on to the next point. This was the explanation of the statement. Pehle point mein aapko kya likhna hai? In simple words, when price of the product increases, demand of the product decreases. When price of the product decreases, demand of the product increases. Then what do you have to write? Hence, there is an inverse relationship between price of the product and its quantity demanded. Ayana. Right? Iske baad aap chota sa table bana sakte hain where you can write price in the first column, then quantity demanded in the second column. When the price increases, quantity demanded decreases. Price decreases, quantity demanded increases. Right? This is the table and this is completion of the statement, explanation of the statement. After completion of explanation of statement, the next point we have is the schedule. What is schedule? Schedule is the tabular presentation of
data.
right? This is the table which we will have in the schedule. As you can see, there are different situations A, B, C, D and E, where there is price of a product. These are the price of rice per kg, and this is quantity demanded of rice in kgs. See, in situation A, price is 10, quantity demanded is 15. Situation B, price is 20, quantity demanded is 40. Situation C, 30, situation 4, 40 and 20, and situation E, 50 and 10, right? This is the schedule per table presentation of our example, which is based on our particular law of demand. Yes or no?
Yes.
Right. What normally happens, students make this schedule, but they do not explain the schedule. Student make this diagram, but they do not explain the diagram. This is the point where they lose marks. If you see the textbook properly, in the textbook also, after the table, after the schedule, the explanation of schedule is given. After the diagram, explanation of diagram is given. So after making the schedule, what we have to write the next point? Explanation of the schedule. What we can write in the explanation of schedule? As shown in the above schedule, as shown in the above table, when the price of the rice is rupees 10 per kg, quantity demanded is 50 kgs. Second point, when price is 20 rupees per kg, quantity demanded is 40 kgs. When the price is 30 rupees per kg, quantity demanded is 30 kgs. Next point, when price is 40, quantity demanded is 20. And so on, when the price is 50, quantity demanded is 10. Right? These all points, all the situations have to be explained point-wise. So there are 5 points which have to be written, where you have to explain the price and its quantity demanded. After writing these points, what is the next point you have to write? Hence, from the above schedule, we can conclude that there is an inverse relationship between price and its quantity demanded. This is completion of explanation of schedule. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes. But
finally, coming to the diagram. The situations A, B, C, D are given here. You have drawn graph in your school. You just have to plot this situation on the given graph. If you join a particular line and you make a curve, DD is the demand curve, which is downward sloping from left to right. This is the diagram you have to draw. What happens? Student draw the diagram, student make the schedule, student write the statement, but they say these are marks nahi mil rahe. कैसे मिलेंगे? स्टेटमेंट लिखा है, स्टेटमेंट का एक्सप्लेनेशन लिखना पड़ेगा. स्केड्यूल लिखा है, स्केड्यूल का एक्सप्लेनेशन लिखना पड़ेगा. डायग्राम लिखा है, डायग्राम का एक्सप्लेनेशन लिखना पड़ेगा. राइट, दिस इज द डायग्राम वी हैव ड्रॉ. नाउ व्हाट इज लेफ्ट आउट? एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ डायग्राम. व्हाट इज लेफ्ट आउट? एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ डायग्राम. यस ऑर नो? हाउ डू वी एक्सप्लेन द डायग्राम? इन द अबव गिवन डायग्राम, प्राइस इज गिवन ऑन द वाई एक्सिस, क्वांटिटी डिमांडेड इज गिवन ऑन द एक्स एक्सिस. Right, A, B, C, D, E are the different situations which denote the combinations as shown in the above schedule. When we draw a curve joining all these particular points A, B, C, D and E, what we come to a conclusion? The conclusion that we can draw is DD, the demand curve, is downward sloping from left to right. Look at this. It is downward sloping from left to right. Left to right. Yes or no? The demand curve is downward sloping from left to right. Right? So what we'll write in the explanation of diagram? First, in the above given diagram, price is on the y-axis, quantity demanded is on the x-axis, DD is the demand curve. The demand curve is, next point ka rakha, demand curve is downward sloping from left to right. This downward sloping demand curve is due to inverse relationship between price and its quantity demanded. What is the thumb rule we have to remember? Whenever there is inverse relationship between two variables, then the negative, the slope of the curve is always negative. Whenever there is direct positive relationship between two variables, the slope of the curve will always be positive, that is upward sloping. In our particular case, the two variables price and quantity demanded have inverse relationship, hence the demand curve is downward sloping from left to right. After writing this, the explanation of diagram is complete. This is what you have to write in the law of demand. What we have written to divide? Introduction, statement of law, explanation of statement, schedule, explanation of schedule, diagram and explanation of diagram. After completing this, you have to write exceptions or assumptions as asked in the question paper, right? Sir, assumptions, exceptions, इतने सारे points लिखने के लिए वक्त कहाँ पर है? Board के नियम और rules के मुताबिक marking criteria के हिसाब से, even if you write 4 exceptions or 4 assumptions is more than sufficient, you will be able to score 100% marks. But advice है आप आपकी लिखने की speed बढ़ाइए. अगर आपको assumptions पूछे गए हैं, ensure that you write all the assumptions completely. You write all the exceptions completely. Write the heading, main heading of the assumptions and explain it in one or two lines. Don't give a long explanation of the assumptions. Just write one or two point in the explanation, that is more than sufficient. How do we remember the points as given in the assumption and exception? There is a small trick, that is the mnemonics or the memory technique which we can use. What is the memory technique for assumptions? No price, size, taste, income, G. Repeat after me. What is the memory technique?
No price, size, taste, income, G.
Yes, once more. No price, size, taste, income, G. One last time. No price, size, taste, income, G. Yes. So, I'll be just reading out the main title. You have to tell me the explanation of same. Yes. N stand for?
No change in expectations about future price changes.
Price?
Price of substitutes and complementary goods remain constant.
Size?
Size and population remains constant.
Taste
and preferences remains constant.
Income
of the consumer remains constant.
And G?
Government policy remains constant.
These are the assumptions. You don't have to worry. All my students who are watching this video, I will be writing down the entire memory technique in the description link, where you can write down or note down this particular assumptions, memory technique and revise the same. What is the memory technique for exceptions? Ignore PSD star PG. You know what is PSD? A course which is to be done after doing your PG. What is PG? Post graduation. Right? A simple memory technique. Sabhi log mere piche dohraenge. Yes, say. Ignore PSD star PG. Yes.
Ignore PSD star PG.
Okay. Tell me the explanation of the points. I stands for?
Ignorance.
P stands for?
Prestige goods.
S stands for?
Habitual goods.
D stands for?
Demonstration effect.
S stands for?
Speculation goods.
P stands for?
Price reasons and?
Consumer psychological bias.
Okay, and G stands for?
Given goods.
Right? So, these are all points we have in the exceptions. See, in the last March examination, March 2019 examination, explain law of demand and exceptions were asked. So my particular case for the February 2020 examinations is to explain law of demand and its assumptions. Is it okay?
Yes.
Right? Lekin, previous bola hai, so we don't have to sit relaxed. We also have to learn the exceptions. Ho sakta hai exceptions aap question number 5 mein puch le, long reasons ke andar puch le, kyunki ye chapter 15 mark ke liye hai. तो एक्सेप्शंस अगर वहां नहीं पूछे तो और कहीं पूछेंगे. नॉर्मली अगर पिछले साल अगर आप देखो एक्सेप्शंस क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 में पूछे हैं तो असम्प्शंस क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 में पूछे या क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 में पूछे हैं. सो एक्सेप्शंस असम्प्शंस दोनों भी इंपॉर्टेंट है. इसके निमोनिक जो है उसका डिटेल एक्सप्लेनेशन मैं आपको इस वीडियो के नीचे वाले लिंक में पोस्ट कर दूंगा. ओके राइट, दिस इज ऑल वी हैव इन द पर्टिकुलर सेक्शन ऑफ लॉ ऑफ डिमांड. आई अश्योर यू कि अगर आप ऐसे लिखते हो और इतना लिखते हो, there is no chance the examiner can cut your single mark. But you have to be very careful. You have to be very prompt, right? You have to write down this particular point. जो margin रहते हैं, margin के अंदर एक inner column में छोटी margin बनाना चाहिए. वहाँ पर आप main heading, sub points लिख सकते हैं, right? While drawing the schedule, you have to name the schedule. While drawing the diagram, you have to name the what is given on the x-axis, what is given on the y-axis, what is that diagram about, right? So this is all we have on the question, explain law of demand and its assumptions and exceptions. In the next video, I'll bring you more videos which are my guest questions for this February 2020 examinations, right? So before I end my particular session, I'll give you 2 minutes to copy whatever is written on this particular board. Yes, note down. Okay, so before I end my lecture, those who wish to write and copy this down, can copy. Yes, start writing. Please subscribe to my channel. Please hit on the bell icon which is given below the video. Please stay connected, stay in touch for more updates on important questions of your board examination. I'll also be bringing important questions on SP also. So thank you so much guys. Thank you so much.